On commercial fisheries, one of the most important items of tackle is your hook. Hook choice is really, really important because you're catching big weights of fish, so they've got to be really durable. We're here today at Western Pools, where I'm going to show you a few tips and tricks on how to use our new GPM hooks. The GPM hooks are available in two types. We've got a spade end and an eyed version. I'm going to start by talking you through the eyed version, which is what I'm using here at Western Pools on the clay pit today. The eyed version is absolutely perfect for shallow fishing for F1s and small to medium sized carp. Plenty powerful enough, but really, really strong. There we go, another F1. Tend to normally start with a size 18 when I'm fishing 4mm pellets or casters on the hook. But then if there's lots and lots of fish about, I won't hesitate in stepping up to a size 16, just so you can pull that a little bit harder and less chance of them coming off. So today, lots of small F1s, the odd better one in between. So we're fishing an 18 at the moment. I always like to use an F1 shortstop kit when shallow fishing for F1s. Just speeds the whole process up. You've only got a very short length of elastic and you really don't have to pull as much out as you would on a long kit. So maybe one or two pulls and your fish will be up on the surface even if it's a big fish. So moving on to the elastic, I'm using an 11 hollow, which some people might think is a little bit strong for a short kit like this, but it's incredibly soft to start with, but powers up quite quickly. So it's ideal for small fish, it will come out a short way. But for bigger fish, you can just give it one or two pulls and you can get them in really, really quickly. So moving on to the main rig now, I like to use a really durable main line, so 015 reflow power. That covers most of my shallow fishing. And then float-wise, it's a Deadship F1 shallow float in a 4x10 size. These are really, really nice when fishing small 4mm pellets and casters. Anything bigger like a 6mm pellet, then I'd move on to the shallow float, which has got a thicker tip. The shotting couldn't be simpler. I've just got a little bulk of number 11 stots right above the 4-inch hook length. It's really, really positive. You may want to string them out a little bit on a hard day, but generally that's the most effective by far. The hook length is 011 reflow power, and that is tied directly to a GPM-B size 18 and a little micro bait band. Again, the micro bait band's perfect for small 4mm pellets in a caster like we're fishing today. And these hooks are just brilliant. They stay sharp all day long and you can catch 100 pound on the same hook. So I've talked to you a bit about the rigs. What we're gonna do now is have a run through of the baits that we use when we're shallow fishing for F1s. So today I've started off on casters, which I quite often do on this sort of venue. They're not so selective, but you'll get plenty of bites early on. So we've had a mixture of F1s and eyed so far, but what I have found is that at times we're getting far too many eyed, so I've had to switch it to pellets, which are a little bit more selective. Just got a small F1 here. So the beauty of the setup that I'm using today is I've got this small size 18 hook and the micro bait band, so I can switch between the casters and the small pellets without having to change my rig at all. Just keep feeding all the time. Another good tip, if you think there's kind of a mixture of F1s and eyed in your swim, then you can carry on feeding the casters to draw the fish in, but if you just band the pellet instead, you'll find that the eyed don't tend to go for it so much, so your bait will be in the water for a little bit longer and hopefully enough time to get all of the F1s. So loads of fish here today, but as I say, a lot of them are very small. Keep on slapping your rig and feeding. So I've just put a pellet on this time, just to see if we can pick up a bigger fish. There we go. Unfortunately, it's not any bigger, but it is the target species in F1. I'm Let's go straight back out, same pellet on. So if you keep feeding and slapping your rig, you're just making loads and loads of noise, which will draw the fish in. There's another one. The water's really clear here on the clay pit, so what you need to do really is, if you keep on feeding it while you've got a fish on, you'll gain the fish's confidence. So as soon as you net this one, there should hopefully be another one back there. This one's a bit better. That 11 hollow is working well. And that's a much better fish, about £3 that one. The GPMs are really, really versatile hooks. I've spoken to you about the hide ones already, perfect for shallow fishing, and now I'm going to go through the spade end versions. Spade end hooks are my go-to hook for commercial fishing. They're suitable for kind of any bait you can think of really, maggots, worms, casters, corn, meat, pellets, just really, really versatile, and you can use them at any time of the year, so that they're equally good in winter as they are in summer when you're fishing for big F1s and kind of small and medium-sized carp. One really, really good feature about the GPM spade end hook is the actual size of the spade. It's a little bit bigger than most spades on the market, which means you can get away with slightly heavier lines. So for example, today down the edge, I'm fishing a size 14 hook. And I can comfortably use an 015 reflow power with no problems at all. So it's really important that you've got the confidence, you know the line is never going to pull over that spade and lose you that potentially match winning fish. One place you really can't ignore on commercial fisheries is the margins. One thing I see a lot of people doing is fishing long down the bank, 13, maybe even 14 metres. It's no good at all when you're trying to catch 200 pound of fish, unless they're really, really big fish. So what I'm doing today is I'm fishing really close to myself, just down here. And the fish are so confident this time of year, you feed bait there and they're coming in straight away. I can see fish down there already. So when you're fishing close to you, you want to fish really robust gear. So I'm fishing a 13 hollow, which is a kind of a medium elastic really, but then the rest of the rig is really durable. So I've got 019 reflow power mainline, an 015 hook length, and then the 14 GPM-B, which is a nice strong hook. And is whether I'm fishing a piece of corn or some casters like I am at the moment, it suits any bait really. Just make sure you fish a really nice heavy float, because you're fishing in shallow water and you don't want the carp to be wafting your float all over the place. There we go, there's one. So you can see there, we've had two or three bites in quick succession, even though the water's that shallow. Take your time with them. Might be an F1, this one. Oh, that smallish carp. Still plenty of fight in it. There we go, a carp of 2 or 3 pounds. That's on size 14 GPM-B with three casters. Right, I'm gonna show you a few more tips for fishing down the edge. Let's put some more bait on this one. One thing I see a lot of people doing is fishing in far too deep of water. On many pools, you can kind of get any depth you want down the edge. So you can get 2 foot, 18 inches, a foot. But then some people fish kind of down the shelf in 3 foot. This time of year when it's warm, you're just going to foul hook far too many fish when you're doing that. You want to be fishing in really shallow water like we are today, in about 18 inches. All the fish that are up there are feeding confidently and you're much less likely to get line bites. Bait choice is also really important when you're fishing down the edge. On the clay pit here at Western, I really like to feed ground bait down the edge because the water's gin clear, and when you put some ground bait in, that first fish that comes into the peg actually helps colour up the swim for you, and then it will in turn attract more fish into the peg. Obviously with the ground bait you need to feed something to actually hold them there as well, so I've actually fed some casters today. I mean, you don't need to feed too many, but the fish in here just love them, and they'll actually stay in the peg for quite a long time. Let's see if we can get this one in. So with the casters, I like to fish that in combination with some corn. So probably feed a few grains of corn, and then you've got an option of two different hook baits. So you can either try three casters on the size 14 GPM hook, or you can use a single piece of corn. That one was on three casters. It seems to be working well today. So let's pop them in the net. So there we go. There's a couple of ways of using our new GPM hooks, which are available from all Preston retailers now.